In a world where technology is advancing at an unprecedented pace, one innovation is revolutionizing the way we interact with computers and the power of language itself. Welcome to the realm of large language models, or LLMs. LLMs are cutting-edge artificial intelligence models that have the ability to understand and generate human-like text with remarkable accuracy and fluency. These models are not just science fiction. They are already making an impact in various fields. Let's explore some of their remarkable applications and an amazing tool introduced by H2O AI, which helps you to create your own LLM. We already discussed LLMs in a previous video, but just to refresh your memory, large language models are a subset of deep learning. We can define it as large, general-purpose language models can be pre-trained and then fine-tuned for specific purposes. LLMs are trained to solve common language problems like text classification, question answering, document summarization, and text generation. By using this foundation model, we can tailor it to solve specific problems in different fields by training with a relatively small size of field dataset. Single model can be used in different tasks. These foundation models are trained with petabytes of data which are smart enough to perform multiple tasks. The fine-tuning process requires minimal field data to tailor LLMs to our own use case. This is beneficial since each and every organization does not have facilities to create their own LLM with huge amount of data. But still, they can get the benefit of this by using a small set of field data to make it reality. H2O LLM Studio is a no-code LLM GUI designed for fine-tuning state-of-the-art large language models. Some of the prominent features in H2O LLM Studio are as below. No-code fine-tuning. With the help of GUI, even NLP practitioners can fine-tune LLMs easily without involving coding expertise. The intuitive GUI now helps you to upload training data, select LLM architecture, and configure hyperparameters easily as they wish. Wide range of hyperparameters. To optimize model performance, this offers a wide variety of hyperparameters for fine-tuning LLMs. Advanced evolution metrics and model comparison. This provides advanced evolution metrics for validating generated answers by the model. Also, to compare different fine-tuned models, the platform offers visual tracking and comparison of model performance capabilities. Instant feedback and model sharing. To get instant feedback, this allows practitioners to chat with their fine-tuned models. Moreover, the platform allows easy model sharing with the community by exporting the fine-tuned model to the Hugging Face Hub, a popular platform for sharing and discovering machine learning models. Make sure to have the following requirements in place before you begin. Ubuntu 16.04 Plus machine with at least one recent NVIDIA GPU. Latest NVIDIA drivers version. Minimum of 24 GB of GPU memory for larger models. Python 3.10 is installed on your machine. You can visit the official GitHub repo for detailed installation instructions. H2O LLM Studio provides several quick and easy ways to get started. It's accessible to customize your LLM via GUI, CLI, or even with popular platforms like Kaggle and Colab. Here, let's walk through the GUI process and you can find the rest of the methods from the links provided in the description. So, after setting up initial requirements, you can navigate to the localhost using the web browser to access H2O LLM Studio. If you see a landing page somewhat similar to this, you have done the installation process correctly. To give an overview of this LLM Studio, let's follow the steps shown here. First, we start with the importing data and we launch experiments. After that, we monitor the experiments. Finally, before we exporting the models, we are comparing those experiments. So, after comparing those experiments, we are going to export these models to the Hugging Face. When you log into the LLM Studio, you will see a homepage like this. At the top left corner, we have a bar chart which gives you a basic overview about the experiment counts. From there, we can identify How many experiments ran successfully, queued, running, and failed? Right after it, we have some summary about CPU and GPU load, memory usage, and detailed GPU stat as well. Below, we have two separate tables which list down our datasets and experiments. Next page, which we have, is called Settings. It has some default project settings which we can adjust from our end. We can leave them as it is if you want. If you want to get some idea about each field, there are tooltips at the end of each item which describes what we can do with them. Settings in this page are categorized into a few sections like Appearance, Default Connector Settings, Default Experiment Settings, and Experiment Maximum Settings. Once after adjusting those settings, you can save them to move forward in the application, or if you need to revert them, you can restore them with the default settings as well. In the next page, we can find an area to upload our own field datasets to the LLM Studio. Here in this page, under the Sources drop-down menu, you have multiple choices to select the way which you wish to upload your dataset. You can upload a file in your local storage, or you can import them from AWS S3 or Kaggle. Or simply, you can drag and drop your file in the middle area of this page. Just to note, the dataset file formats which allows to use within LLM Studio are ZIP, CSV, or PQ files. To list down all datasets that are imported to the LLM Studio, we can move into the View Datasets page. While you are importing your dataset, in the previous page, you have to fill a form with some information as shown here. In this table, we can see those data in each column. At the end of each dataset, we have several other options as well. We can create new experiments by using that dataset. We can edit or delete this dataset as well. You can click on a dataset in the table and expand it with more information. It opens with four new tabs. The first tab is called Sample Train Data. It shows the content in our selected dataset. The main two columns which we need to highlight here are the instruction and output. This is based on question and answering structure. So we need to train our model with those questions to give the answers as in the output column. When we are preparing a dataset, this should be in our mind. In the sample train visualization section, we have our content in the dataset in a more realistic way. It clearly shows our questions and relative answers there. Also, we have some other tabs which give more summary and statistics regarding our dataset. The next major page that makes this LLM Studio more unique is called Create Experiments. As an NLP practitioner, you are probably working with many parameters while you are fine-tuning your own LLM. The beauty of LLM Studio is, you no need to code anything from your end. You have a GUI which brings all of them to your fingertips. Here you can see there are many parameters that you can adjust by yourself that are categorized in this page. Dataset settings, tokenizer settings, architecture settings, and many more. Same as previous pages, in each setting area, it has a tooltip which describes the meaning of it. To give a basic overview on these settings, let's start with general settings. Here we can choose the dataset that to use in this experiment. If you have imported multiple files, you can pick one out of them from here. Then we can define the problem type and give an experiment name. The LLM backbone option is the most important setting as it sets the pre-trained model weights. For quicker experiments, it's recommended to use a one with smaller size, and for higher accuracy, good to go with a larger model. Also, you can use any Hugging Face model here. It's not restricted to use the listed options in the drop-down menu. Other than that, I would like to highlight another setting which is in the prediction settings area. Here we can define the metric to evaluate the model's performance. If you are dealing with some sensitive dataset, it's preferred not to use GPT 3.5 or GPT 4 as evaluation metric since it uses OpenAI APIs. I'm not going over each and every settings here. Once after tuning your parameters, you can run your experiment. The next cool feature here is we can view how the model we fine-tuned are performing. We have a separate page called View Experiments. It lists down all the experiments which you ran in our LLM Studio with some information shown in a table. At the end of each experiment, it has few other options as well, like stop or delete experiment, rename experiment. To get more insights about a particular experiment, you can click and move inside to an experiment. It will open a set of new tabs as shown here. In the chart section, you can get plots regarding learning rate, training loss, and validation metric value throughout the training process. In the summary section, it gives a basic summary regarding the experiment. Next, in the Train Data Insights section, it shows the model first batch, so you can verify your input data representation is correct. Moreover, it shows how this processes your data, and it will be helpful to figure out any issue at the early stage of the experiment. The next interesting tab we have here is Validation Prediction Insights. It shows the model's predictions for random, best, and worst validation samples here. This will show you how well your model generalizes for the new data. Next tab is related to the logs that will be helpful to track if we faced any issue while in the process. Also, in the config tab is list all settings we tuned while we created the experiment. Next most interesting part here is we have a chatbot which uses the model which we created with this particular experiment. So we can have some conversations here and see how well our model performs. This will give some fresh experience to the end users of LLM Studio. You can see there are a couple of options at the bottom of the page while you are walking through an experiment. We can download logs, predictions, and models as well. So if you are willing to share your model with a wider audience, here you have an option to push the model to the Hugging Face Hub. For that, you need to have a Hugging Face API key with write access. You can generate it by yourself by following the instructions in the Hugging Face Hub. Finally, it has a feature to compare our experiments as well. So you can select experiments in the table and click the Compare Experiments button. In the first tab, it shows all the charts which showed experiment-wise together now. Also, it shows all the configs we used in those experiments in a single table. That will be helpful for us to make a comparison easily.
So I hope you guys got a basic overview on this amazing open source platform which helps you to create your own LLMs. With a set of features, this tool provides NLM practitioners with a powerful means to customize language models to suit their particular tasks and domains quickly and effectively. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.